My husband and I pastor a church. I lead worship every Sunday. My public service did not just begin yesterday or last week. I also retired from the United States Air Force Reserve after more than 21 years. Go veterans. I'm a member of the NAACP, NCFW, and CAB. And as I serve on in the Senate, I serve on several committees. One, Defense and Homeland Security, which is veterans issues, and in that committee, we pass out bills that concern veterans. One, veterans can now receive their driver's license for free. They can use their ID to vote. They can use their ID for notary public documents. I also serve on public safety. I serve on retirement, which deals with state employees, including our teachers, so that we can make sure that our teachers' benefits are not diminished. I also serve on, MARTOC. I serve on Special Judiciary. I'm a member of the Working Families Caucus, which we continue to fight for livable wages, Medicaid expansion. I also serve on the Women's Caucus, serve as a member of the Women's Caucus. In the Women's Caucus, we deal with issues that concern women, faith, children, and families. Again, my name is Tanya P. Anderson, and I am the State Senator for Senate District 43.
Good morning, DeKalb County.
Good morning. Good morning.
My name is Joel Thibodeau. I'm a candidate for the Senate District 43 in the Georgia State Senate. I'm currently employed as the Director of Internal Audits and Compliance at the DeKalb County School District. I also served as the Chair of the Governor's Commission on the City of Stonecrest. I'm a former Senate staffer, having served on the Senate Budget Evaluation Office, where I assisted in writing the state budget and also evaluated tax plans, including the omission of the birthday tax on your tags every year. Prior to that, I also worked in my neighborhood as a volunteer, as an HOA president. So now, why am I running? Well, in this age of Trump, and at this time when the Republican Party is trying to extend and expand its bloody red control of state government, it is now time for substantive, meaningful, energetic, effective, and inclusive representation. We can no longer afford to remain asleep at the wheel or support office holders who are on cruise control. You have to ask yourself, who works for who? And who stands for you? We have groups of people at the state government who will make deals with their colleagues, who will work with their colleagues, and then not listen to you, but after the session come back and tell you that what they've done is what's best for you. Never having listened to your concerns, never having listened to what you want for yourselves and in your community. I'm running to change all that. My name is Joel Thibodeau. I've always stood with the people. I will always stand for the people. And I need you to send me to the State House so I can stand for you. Woo!
Senator Anderson, Georgia ranks second from the bottom in childhood obesity, endangering our children with lifelong chronic disease. What, if anything, can state policy do to address this dilemma?
Thank you for asking that question. One of the things that state policy has done as far as our children and obesity are concerned, we just passed a bill that, and I was a part, my vote was there, I'm already there making it happen, that we have recess for our children, grades K through five, so that they are mobile, so that they are active, so that they are operating at their highest potential, not just educationally, but physically. We can't continue to produce children who are obese and without proper access to foods. The other thing is that we are identifying food deserts so that our children and families, as a member of the Working Families Caucus, can have access to those amenities. Thank you.
question to you. Should I repeat that?
I don't.
Okay.
I do believe that the bill that passed restored recess to school is excellent. We also have to look at our nutrition programs in the school to make sure that kids are not accessing the junk that they have access to in the schools through vending machines and vending contracts.
Amen.
If we are going to have vending machines in the schools, then they should have healthy snacks and healthy alternatives and not the junk that they have now. We also need to look at after school and summer programs. One of the things driving obesity is simply sedentary lifestyles. Kids sit in front of the television, they're babysat by the television, they're playing video games, they are no longer outdoors playing, participating in sports, and doing things over the summer while their parents at work. I believe that state funding should be directed to those programs, and I'll be the one to fight for them.
Recently, we've seen so many, especially young people, bringing up a lot of issues impacting our state that they feel are very important. And as an advocate, Mrs. Anderson, I want to know, what is one of the number one challenges you believe are facing this state? Hopefully, you can incorporate young people in that particular statement. And how would you address this challenge? I'm saying that I'm seeing a lot of just young people in general, people get involved politically and actively in our state. And I know as a state representative, I want to see what you believe is one of the main issues challenging our state, and how do you feel that you can address that issue?
So one of the issues that I feel is a challenge to our young people and to our children within the state, we just had several issues concerning gun violence. The main issue that I have opposed time and time again, year after year, we just had the walkout of the chamber, 17 minutes, where we advocated with the teens, with the youth, so that they would know that we are standing with them, and we are creating laws and standing on laws that defy guns, access to guns in every place. It's a sad day that we have them in our churches. You know, allowed in our churches, allowed in our schools. We can't continue to allow that type of access. And it's not that I'm against the Second Amendment, right? It's just that we have to have responsibility when we handle weapons and handle guns. And so that's one of the things that I would like to include and incorporate our young people and teens in, as well as others.
I do believe that gun violence is a scourge on the community, and especially involving young people. So many people that are gunned down, that are suspects in crimes, are our youngest people. But in that vein, we also need juvenile justice reform. We have a juvenile justice system that seems to be bent on creating more criminals instead of reforming them.
Amen.
We also have to look at college costs. A lot of our young people are rising through high school and are looking at going to college, but the costs are prohibitive. There's no reason why a 22-year-old should graduate from college with leading prospects for a job, but $40,000 to $50,000 in debt. One of the ways that state government can address that is more funding to career technical training so that our kids can get an affordable education that goes directly to a job, and also early college academies, which cuts the time in college in half with kids that graduate with high school diplomas and college degrees, and they only have to pay for the other 2 years. Thank you.
Senator Anderson, I'd love to hear your 1 minute closing remark.
Thank you so much for the opportunity to come and be with you this morning. But I want to say that as the state senator for Senate District 43, I have already implemented bills and laws that concern our community. I have already stood and fought for working families. I have already stood and fought for women and children as a member of the Women's Caucus. But one of the main things that I have continued to do is be involved in our schools and our communities. I have not been appointed by the governor on any commission or any board, but I have been voted in by the people. My name is Tanya B. Anderson, and I ask for your continued support and for your vote on May 22nd.
Yes, the one thing I can tell you is that I will work for you. The emphasis being on work and the emphasis being on you. The things that I've done have been voluntary. I have not been paid a dime for any of the work that I have done in this community, as much as I've done. When I go to the State House, I will propose legislation. One bill being proposed over the course of a term is not acceptable. When you show up at the State House, you have to have the people's concerns in mind. You have to bring it to the legislative council, and you have to file bills on behalf of your folks. Local bills, general bills, policy bills, procedural bills, I will do that for you. I will not sit and take your tax money and hold a position and not do the work of the people. My name is Joel Thibodeau. I want your support. I will support you. Thank you.
Thank you. You all may exit the platform.